doesn't feel good. So I try to help them, and, you know, that's something I learned. You know, I relate to people. Like, Jeremy and I see, like I commented before, we see a lot of gangbangers come through to talk to us from the other side because we relate to them. You know, no one else accepts them. So very few people understand or take the time to show love. And, like, for some reason, I felt drawn to talk to them. I relate, you know.
Oh, they're killers.
They're killers, and they're bad. And they're not like that. You know, they might be killing people, yeah. All right, they're killing each other. But
there's a good example. You're not being judged, you know, necessarily. You're not being judged from people, but you're not being judged by the infinite on this side or that side.
That's right.
You know, remember that when you move forward in your life and you doubt yourself and you hate yourself for doing this or you're angry at yourself. You know, you're not going to have to go face, you know, some kind of trial once you cross over. Are you a good person or a bad person?
It's not like only you can make that decision.
Yeah,
you judge yourself.
You're only human, I mean, in this lifetime. So, you know, like I said, there's so many things spread out there and given to you to make mistakes. How can you not make mistakes?
Yeah, it's meant to be. You're supposed to make some mistakes and learn from them.
Absolutely.
It's part of the process. So.
And some people consider some mistakes bigger than others, but we try not to do that. You know, that's one thing we try not to do, judgment. You know,
like I said, like, you know, like that's why we talked about, like, we deal with a lot of people who've like died violently or gangbangers or we talk to families whose friends and family members have been murdered. You know, we talk to both sides of the coin. We talk to people who killed people, people who've lost people. And a lot of times, like, they lost people too. Like, these gangbangers lose their friends too. And then, like, they're going back and forth taking revenge. And somebody kills the blood, and then the blood go kill a Crip, let's say, or whatever it works out to be. Or this set gets mad and goes to war with another set, man, and they're just killing each other over little differences. But the infinite's not upset about that and not throwing anyone in some hell. You know, like, it's a good thing to say. Like, I don't know why I talk about this a lot, but it's a good example about forgiveness, too. You know, to say that we've seen them forgive each other, like the person who killed someone that they both crossed over, you know, the killer and the killed. And they're gangbangers. Sometimes they greet each other, and then they'll forgive one another on the other side, you know? They'll come to say that.
Yeah, and you know, like, you know, I want to just comment on, like, one thing. It's like, we're all equal. A good way to look at this is equality. You know, sometimes they want people to go out in the woods and filter out the deer, you know, because we got too many deer. We got to kill them all.
Yeah.
You know, well, I think, in a way, you know, a lot of times, you know, a lot of war and a lot of things, God's filtering, or I would say the infinite, because I would say God himself. I don't really like to use that word so much, but there is a reason for everybody to go, you know. It's not just random, you know.
Correct.
This was either their plan, it probably was their plan to go that way. And you know, the mothers and the fathers say, oh, my son, and they cry and they fall apart and they pass. And my daughter's passed, they got killed. You know, but there's a reasoning behind that mean, you know, maybe, you know, you don't understand, you know, or you have to open yourself to understanding that too.
There's more than meets the eye on what happened.
Yeah.
It could be even something that happened in another lifetime. A lot of the time it is. It goes back, it might go back decades or centuries or millennia to another life that person's been through, and the person who killed that person this lifetime has gone through. It could be karma is being worked out. You never know.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not trying to justify anything, but I'm saying that there's always more than meets the eye.
I'm not saying killing anything or anyone is the answer, but it happens.
It happens.
You know, saying if it's unfortunate or fortunate or supposed to happen or not supposed to happen, who's to say, you know?
Find out when you get to the other side sometimes and you look at the life and the whole big picture.
Mm-hmm.
Once you yourself get to the spirit world and look at if your friend has died that way and you look at his life and other people, then you might understand more, you know?
Right, right.
It's not always, it's a lot to it, you know?
There is a lot to it. That's what we're trying to step in and try to help people, you know, people understand that, you know, everything is kind of happening for a reason. You know,
mm-hmm.
Best thing to do is try to look at it in a new perspective, you know.
That's right.
I wanted to comment on something. You know, I try to write something positive on my board every day, and today I want to give a shout out to the Beatles and Paul McCartney and John Lennon, Ringo Starr, George Harrison. But I wrote, in the end, the love you make equals to the love you take. And it can go either way. In the end, the love you take equals to the love you make. I just wanted to say, you know,
Paul McCartney saying that at the end of a song.
Yeah,
Beatles song.
At the end of Abbey Road, that was like the word of wisdom that he spit out. And let me say, you know, it's true. You know, if you make a lot of love, you probably receive a lot of love. You know, you take a lot of love, you know, you make a lot of love. So try not to turn that word into hate or anything like that. You know, try to do the best you can to make love, take love, not make hate, take hate.
That's right. Very important to think about that like that. It's like a lot to that. That's good wisdom.
Good wisdom, Paul. Or whoever wrote it in the group, you know, but he sung it, so.
Yeah.
I just wanted to say that.
That's something to say, too. Like, I think I might have mentioned it before. I think so, but sometimes people writing song lyrics will accidentally include things. Not accidentally, but unknowingly include spiritual truths in their song. And, like, even if they're not open spiritually, even if they're an atheist writing a song, you know, the universe still might use them to put in something that they don't even know it's a truth, you know, but it's in there. And someone will recognize it if they hear it.
Let me touch on atheists a little bit, because being people that don't believe in God are still being led by the infinite.
That's
know?
Right. That's
you
right.
Know, maybe not the God that they're trying to deny so much, you know, with a long beard and the robe and all that.
That's what they're denying, but that's not what's going on anyways.
Yeah. So, I mean, you know, I guess what I'm trying to say is, like, you know, like, when I write songs, when I'm a songwriter, you know, a lot of times the words are just pouring out of my head. I don't even know where they're coming from. A lot of times, you know, I can give myself the credit, but a lot of times the infinite, you know, these words just kind of pop up, just like a bad day would pop up, or a good day, or a good thought, or a bad thought. It just pops up, and it's like, here, right now. And sometimes I keep it, sometimes I don't, but... you know, the words of wisdom are coming through musicians, poems, poets, talent, comedians. We said this before, but, you know, when you have a talent, and what if your talent was walking around the block? Something good is coming out of that.
Yeah, even walking around the block, you could be sending unknowingly pouring out vibrational energy into people, you know, and that's your job. You know?
Absolutely. You want to do that every day? That's what makes you feel good?
Do it.
Because those vibes are going out.
You know, and that's reminded me of something to touch about in the next video. That's what Casey was asking about yesterday. It just came to mind when you said that. That's another question we could answer for, I think a lot of people wondered this. How do you send energy? I explained to him about using his mind and spiritual energy, how to put it into people and how to manipulate energy and send it out and use it to work with people and changing people for the better. Mm-hmm. You know, like, we'll touch on that in the next video because we only got a couple minutes left on this one. All right, I use the spiritual energy, how to send it out. That's something that you can do a lot. That's a good thing to do, learn how to do is send out. Send your energy out because it benefits people.
We got to wrap this one up,
and we'll be right back with the third part.
Peace.